Most Australian leaders were not as interested as I was because they've never been they've never had an emotional event with the arts, a truly emotional event. In other words, if you hand yourself over to the arts, particularly music, but in other forms of art, your mind opens up. There's another realm outside the temporal realm. But if you're talking to somebody who only takes the cabinet papers home of a night, goes to their motel room, reads the cabinet papers and gets up with the newspapers, you're wasting your breath and your energy trying to tell them how important the arts are. But they're important to me. I mean, I often say to people, and you've seen me say, that the Australian economy was reformed off the back of Gustav Mahler, Anton Bruckner and Mr. Shostakovich. But that's completely true.
How long would you spend each evening, for example?
Depends what mood took me. You know, I might have a sort of cello concerto on or some songs by Schubert or something. Or if I went bigger, you know, it was like a Bruckner symphony or something. I mean, I'd walk out of those things. I remember Michelle Grattan asked me one time, just before a budget, he said, what'd you do this morning, Andrew? And I said, well, I was actually listening to Richard Strauss's last four songs. He said, what? What is this? You see, if you get the expansion running, if you get the imagination moving on the big plane, the cabinet material are just cracks in the floorboards of history. Dust in the cracks of the floorboards of history. You know, you can get across the stuff easily in a much bigger, more confident way. If you let the geniuses play with your head.
It's probably some good advice to the current crop of politicians. Do you think any of them get that?
Well, you've got to take... This is all about time. Particularly with music. You know, music is the greatest form of the arts, and you've got to give it time. You can't listen to this work washing up the dishes or reading a cabinet submission. You've got to listen. But it promotes... It's a massive promoter of imagination. And I used to always have the pen beside me if I was hearing me to write things down I was thinking of as they were coming, you know. So it's meant a lot to me. And I believe the arts are central to a nation. You know, they hold the mirror up to the country. They sort of define what we are and what we've become. And those people who think, oh, well, it's good to look arty and turn up at an art show, it's a great pity because they're missing the main point.